Modi's visit to Nepal, aspirations and expectations. Prime Minister Narendra Modi will be on a two-day visit to Nepal, beginning from Sunday. What one can expect from his visit? Will it be a success? The fact that an Indian Prime Minister is paying a bilateral visit to such an intimate neighbor after 17 long years shall energize the relationship. With his election campaigning beaming to Nepali homes, he is already a rock star of sorts in the Himalayan nation. Modi's visit to Pashupatinath will symbolize cultural and religious link. He will also be the first foreign head of government since 1990 to address Nepal's parliament. Instead of developing its hydropower potential, meeting domestic demands and exporting power to India, Nepal today faces crippling shortages and imports electricity from India. A broad power cooperation agreement may be signed. India will promise to expedite delayed infrastructure projects, and there may be a big ticket announcement to deepen connectivity between the two countries. With all these, the PM's visit will safely be declared a hit. Yet, if Modi wants to set a new template for the relationship, he needs to address a fundamental question. What should be India's role in Nepal's domestic politics? New Delhi-Kathmandu ties are complex because India is an established actor in Nepal's internal political evolution. This is partly because New Delhi seeks to shape outcomes to ensure friendly governments. Different factions in Nepal's fragmented polity trend to seek India's support to counter domestic arrivals. This stems in fact that each political stream in Nepal has linked with corresponding political movements in India, increasing the stakeholders. The open border and Kathmandu structural dependency also makes this different from just another interstate relationship. But it is not business as usual internally because Nepal's second constituent assembly is trying to draft a constitution to institutionalize political changes of past decade. From war to peace, from monarchy to republic, from Hindu kingdom to secularism, and from a unitary to a potential federal state. In fact, India first tried to push a compromise on federalism, encouraging its Medici friends to be flexible. Now, both sides, the NC on one hand and the Maoist Medici combined on the other, being lobbying New Delhi to exert pressure on the other to agree their respective model of federalism. India then decided to stay out. There was no mediator and the CA's term ended in May 2012 without a constitution. It is his main field that Modi will have to navigate as contentious issues begin to be debated in the second CA. It can keep an entirely hands-off approach. This would insult India from an backlash. But given the deeply entrenched nature of this role, completely detached is not feasible or likely. It could support broader constitutional principle but stay away from the details. During her visit last week, External Affairs Minister Sushma Swaraj spoke of an inclusive constitution. Also speak of a durable, inclusive and democratic constitution. This conveys the right message about accommodating diversity and seeking the widest possible consensus. It would be best if Modi in his speech to Nepal Parliament says unequivocally that India supports a federal democratic secular republican constitution for Nepal.